incidents as a preference for the habitual voyeur of what is known as. A morning suit can be avoided if you take a route straight through what is known as. John Scott Brewer's group, he gets intimidated by the dirty pigeons. They love a bit of him. Who's that cut Lord marching? You should cut down on your pork life, mate. Get some exercise.
All the people, so many people, they all go hand in hand, hand in hand for their pork life.
You know what I mean?
I get up when I want, except on Wednesdays when I get rudely awakened by the dustman. I put my trousers on, have a cup of tea, and I think about leaving the house. I feed the pigeons, I sometimes feed the sparrows too. It gives me a sense of enormous well-being. And then I'm happy for the rest of the day, safe in the knowledge there will always be a bit of my heart devoted to it.
People, so many people, they all go hand in hand through their pub life.
It's got nothing to do with your four-sprung dirge technique, you know. And it's not about you joggers who go round, 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 round.
All the people, so many people, and they all
to do seat, you know. And it's not about you joggers who go round.
It's his birthday today, my boy. It's nice. George Jennings, I love you immensely. Yeah, as I say, I'm not into public speaking as I don't do talking. Chairman are there to be seen and not heard. I'm not going to go through the thank yous that Craig has done, only to reiterate what he said. Apparently I've offered bonuses to make us the top team at Parkside, which we'll have a little word about that later, because that's not true. You've done it yourself, so thank you for that. But seriously, James, thank you for what you've done with your team. We've got what we wanted. We've got a proper football team in a proper stadium, and next year we'll be doing that. Next year, we'll be with the. Just to reiterate what Craig just said then. What we've got in here tonight would have been a good attendance last year at Millfield, and we've turned it into the best part of 300 people every week. A lot of whom are here tonight, new supporters, chap up the bar, thank you for what you've done over the back there. Every single one of you, Fred, kind of your little table over here. Steve, even though you won, you're a Tottenham supporter, but I love you immensely, thanks for coming every week. And what we get at away games now is fantastic. I've even started singing behind goals and things, and it's a complete nonsense, but we'll have that going as well next year. What else did I want to say? Done the supporters bit. It's the last 12 months, 18 months have been murder getting this stadium over the line, and it has been probably the worst time of my life. But we've got here eventually. The chap that's been standing up here talking, he obviously can't thank himself. But if anybody ever doubted Craig Johnson. I apologise if I get emotional, but because he knew I would, he put me up here to say a few thank yous, because he said, I can't say that, I'll cry, but and probably because he knows I will, but of all the managers we've had, everyone, Craig's just out of blind. He only does what he's told by the manager, and our football club is so lucky to have him. Without him, we wouldn't be where we are today, and from what I know, that will remain with me, will always remain with me. We're here because we're Averley. We're here because we want to be here for Averley. And if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be. It's as simple as that. So never doubt him. Never, ever doubt what he does. And Craig, I love you. Good man is a good woman, and Lynn Johnson, stand up please. Again, what is With Craig and Lynn, again, it takes a partnership, and what that lady has done, I really can't say because it would make me cry, but Lynn, no one's got a clue what you two have done, what you continue to do, because if they did, well, they'd be falling at your feet saying thank you, and everyone should. Because without those two people, this club wouldn't function, it wouldn't be here, and that's not to belittle the like myself, the other members of the committee, but what they have done.
Thank you to sort of all the fans, all the supporters who come along and support us sort of week in, week out. With the, sort of the attendances and things like that have massively been boosted since last year. It's a massive bonus to the players, and sort of the support we get from you guys is huge. So if you can continue that next season, hopefully we'll put in the work on the pitch, and we'll get promoted next year, which is what everyone wants. I just want to say a big thank you to obviously all the management staff, Salt, who isn't here tonight, Webster, Smithy, and obviously George, all the work you do behind the scenes and things like that. It goes unnoticed. Obviously, as players, we appreciate all the work you've been doing throughout the year to get us away from that relegation places and finish above grade. So it's been a good year. And of course, obviously, like you say, sort of Graham and Craig and things like that, all the support, all the committee. This stadium, it's a pleasure for us to train here, to play here, and yeah, we're really thankful for all the support you've given us. So let's go again next year.
Sold out all the floor seats. Take me on a trip, I'd like to go someday. Take me to New York, I'd like to see LA. I really want to come pick it with you. Would you be my American boy? He said, hey sister, it's really nice to meet ya. I just met this 5'7" guy who's just my type. Like the way he's speaking, his confidence is speaking. Don't like his baggy jeans, but I'ma like what's underneath them. And no, I ain't into NYA. I heard the Cali never rains and New York's on the way. First let's see the West End. I show you to my bedroom. I'm liking this American boy, American boy. Thank you.